Hey everybody, how's it? Aloha. Jeebs here, your old composer, hence the Decomposer Lounge. Breaking down some acoustic music for this week. This is my summer acoustic session series week. First time I'm trying this. It's been really super successful with Chris Cornell and Corey Taylor. And now, Pearl Jam's Unplugged Black. I have been getting a lot of requests for stuff. Unfortunately, some of the videos that I would like to do are on the Vivo profile or whatever it is. It's got the little logo there. And that's an instant global block for me. So I'm trying to find the videos that you guys are suggesting that don't, that'll, you know, be a little more liberal. Hopefully I won't get blocked. So, and remember, if I'm not getting to your tracks that you're suggesting this week, don't worry. Because once a week I'm going to do an acoustic. I think I might, I don't know exactly when, but once a week I'm going to do acoustic music. So anyhow, I want to thank you guys, per usual, for your support. As you know, any advertisement, what happens? Doesn't monetize the channel. It goes for a copyright claim. So if you want to buy me a cup of coffee, super cool beans. It also helps what I do with the kids. And as far as the kids concerned, also if you go and check out some of my merch, 100% of these shirts, the proceeds, 100% goes to Kapi'olani Women's and Children's. Matter of fact, I'm going to be making a presentation soon, and you'll all be proud. Anyhow, so that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. So here we go. Pearl Jam's Black, MTV Unplugged. All right. Well, I mean, this is really, really super close in the original arrangements, obviously, from the album. Now, that being said, you know, one of the reasons is that even this song in the performance on the album was kind of very mellow compared to the other songs on 10. But once again, what makes this really super, you know, cool to me is you hear all the nuances and you hear... because it's a live performance and stuff. You hear the layered arrangements building up in the second verse. You know, that's when the bass starts to move around a little more. Also, you see the other arrangement that comes in here is the other guitar player that's holding kind of a melodic pattern while the guitar that started off in the beginning, which was the rhythm section, is still going. And of course, you know, for all of us that know about this song, you know, the wonderful thing to me about the 10 album, let alone this performance, was the range in the intervals. Well, how about this? In the intervals and the melodies. He, you know, Eddie was not afraid to to really jump around. If you don't know, once again, if you don't know what an interval is when it comes to writing a melody, it's the space between the notes, not the quiet space, but, you know, if you want da, da, no space, very little space, da, da, huge interval jump. And when he does that whole little da, 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 and also in an acoustic setting too, a lot more intimate. You know, the energy of the band plus the energy of the audience is, you know, kind of forming this particular performance. Something else I want to kind of glam on really quick, which I automatically noticed, is you can hear with definitive clarity the ghost notes on the snare that are being played. And if you don't know what ghost notes, you know, the ghost notes are in between your obvious boom, pa, doom, pa. You'll hear the snare have a little ticket, ticket, pa. But those small little notes in the back, those are called ghost notes. Anyhow, most of you know that. I just, every now and then, kind of like want to go into that Mr. Rogers mode. All right, let's continue on.
Take a walk outside. I'm surrounded by some kids in pain. Ooh, I can feel their laughter. Oh, why do I see it? And twisting thoughts that spin.
Something else I wanted to bring up here was, did it sound at the very beginning of the second verse where I came in that the right guitar or the main guitar kind of dropped out for a second? I don't know if that was an arrangement decision or if something technical may have happened. Something else I want to bring up as well is that we have two guitar players, but two completely different guitars that are being, be it acoustic, you know, you have, you know, your standard acoustic guitar to the left. Left on this, right in the cans. And on the left, you have that other guitar. I don't know the name and the style of that guitar that has the metal around it that the guy on the left of this video is playing. But that makes for a really unique separation in the performance. Two different sounding types of guitars, which is, you know, when you're doing acoustic performance, sometimes because of the fact that some of the arrangements kind of get played down a bit. Sometimes making a decision to have two different types of guitars being played works really well for the actual mixing. And that's another thing for the mixing of this. I don't know if this was remixed afterwards. I'm pretty sure at least before, because they may have released a mastered version of this, an album from MTV back in the day. But the live mixing on this is really super, super good. It still sticks to the dynamics of what you're looking at. And what I mean by that is, when you're looking at the video, you're looking this way, so this, your right, you know, side is matching the performance on stage left. Or is that how you say it? If you look out that way, is it stage left? I'm not a live musician performer, so I don't know exactly all the terms. And then, of course, when they start coming in with that arrangement, that is one of those secondary hooks in a song that I always listen for, or at least is something else that draws me in. But without a doubt, another thing is just the energy in which Eddie's singing. He still brings in a little bit of what he's got as far as when he's, you know, all loaded up with the band, completely, you know, dialed into their rock gear. But at the same token, he just always had such a unique sound in his lower performance range and stuff like that. I'm not a vocal coach, but you can hear him. You could close your eyes and he could do it like I just did. Eddie with the ukulele. Remember, he did the ukulele songs with Wyatt, one of my puppets for the kids' reaction stuff that I do. And it was really cool because even though he was in his, you know, with the ukulele, the whole album is ukulele. Second he opens his mouth, you could just know it's just Eddie. Anyhow, let's continue on. All right. Maybe it was me, but I heard like it seemed what seemed like a secondary arrangement in the back, some very high sound. It could have been a harmonic tone from the guitar, if the guitar was being played up there or something, but it sounded like there was almost another arrangement in the back. But I just looked on the stage and there isn't, it's just the guys. So but once again, when it comes to an acoustic performance, the intimacy of it, even in the setup of the show or the way these videos are recorded, it's very intimate settings. There are acoustic performances that have happened at super large stadium style or you know, really huge places and stuff. But in general, at least the videos that I've watched thus far, the acoustic performances also are shot in intimate areas. And therefore you can get a little bit of a nicer audience response, which is really a little more personal. But what's cool about that is because is at that point you can actually hear separate voices when they're in the background cheering you on. And I don't know if you heard it, but at the end of this, did you hear a whistle? Like somebody had whistled? It kind of reminded me at the end of Benny of the Jets, that live Elton John track. There was always that one whistle at the end you always waited to hear. But anyhow, true to form, Pearl Jam, this unplugged version of Black, very moving, very powerful. For me in particular, with my soundtrack of life, I knew exactly where I was at that point, or at that, you know, period in time in life, and I'm sure you guys do. When you first heard Black, do you remember where you were? How did it make you feel? Anyhow, thank you guys for hanging out. Thank you for, you know, being patient with me through the acoustic week. I'm getting some really great responses, and so probably should have started this earlier, but this channel is a whole new journey. I'm only 7 months into it, so God knows where I'm going to be spinning around. Once again, I want to thank you guys. Just in case you want to buy me a cup of coffee, the link will be down below. The link will be down below for the merch as well, that the shirts and stuff that's going to, the proceeds go to Kapi'olani Women's and Children. I also have Patreon if you want to check that out. I just did my very first Tool lyrical review on Reflection, I believe it was, yeah. And that went really well. Pulled out a whole different way of me listening to things. I think I'm going to do that a lot more often as well. Anyhow, guys, thank you so much. Have a killer day. Couple more days worth of acoustic, then we get back into the banging rock and roll. You guys take care. All right.
right.